How do you screen record with sound on the iPhone? You're gonna find out how easy this is, and this is really convenient. You're gonna use this all the time. Okay, in this episode, I'm gonna show you how to do just that, screen record with sound on your iPhone. I'm gonna show you how to do it on a Mac as well. All right, now check this out. When I scroll down, look right there. There's a button with a circle on it. That is the button that records my screen. If you don't see that button there, just go into your settings and you can control what widgets appear on your screen here. Now, if I hold it, then another menu comes up and you see this thing down here that says microphone off. I can turn it on. So now if I record my screen, it's got a countdown timer right there. Then I can just navigate wherever I want on my phone. I can go into my email. I can scroll around and I can talk and it records audio. To stop, I just come up here where that red dot is and I hit that, hit the stop button that appeared, and now it saved it into my photos. So I can come here to my photos, I can find that one, turn on the sound.
Want on my phone, I can go into my email.
Isn't that awesome? And isn't that easy? Okay, so now I've got my laptop set up and I used to use Snagit for a long time. That's made by Camtasia, which the company is TechSmith. I actually recommend against Snagit now because the longer your recording time, the more risk there is of the file just vanishing and disappearing. So I found another one I'm going to show you right here. It's browser-based. It's called Screencastify. So when I open up, I have to install a Chrome plugin. When I have the Chrome plugin installed, I can just come right here, click on that little icon, and I can hit record. If I have multiple displays, I get to choose between them. I've only got one display, so I turn that on, and then I hit share. And then I've got my countdown. Right now it's recording the whole screen, so I can scroll around. It's recording my voice, which is amazing. I can point at things. And then when I'm done, I just come down here to the controls at the bottom left and hit stop, and it opens up a new tab showing my video. So the audio is not playing because it's muted, but I can rewind it. I can trim it if I want, and then I can share it in a variety of ways. So I can just copy a share link. The way that I have this set up is it's automatically uploaded to the cloud with Screencastify, but if I want to download it myself or if I want to upload it to YouTube, then I click on this menu right here. I've already got my YouTube login set up for the channel I would want to send this to. I could export it to YouTube right there, or I could just save as an MP4. Like when I do this, it says that I want to convert to a fixed frame rate. I can choose that frame rate and then hit export. And it converts the file. I can save it and do whatever I want with it. So I love those tips. I use those tools all the time, and I want to share a lot more resources with you. I teach people how to leverage YouTube to generate leads for their business, and I want to give you my book. Now, what this book is, it's a hero's guide to influence on YouTube. I packed in here all of my strategies that I've used on over 50 different YouTube channels to leverage YouTube to generate leads for their business. And we're talking to the tune of 7 and 8 figures per year in their business just from YouTube leads. So if you'd like to learn how to do that, this is my gift to you as long as you cover the shipping cost. Go to natesyoutubebook.com and that's my gift to you.